All right, guys, what's going on? This is your boy, Lago, one half of Endure, and tonight I have the venerable, my second man in control, if anything. If I can't get my sister, I got the man who backed me up, Triple M on the mic. Trip, what's going on?
No, I'm doing fine. I'm trying to keep things lowbrow.
Okay, lowbrow it is. All right, guys, it's been a long time, right, since I've done an LBC.
Quite a while, too.
Yes, LBC. But I might got to do an LBC at, I'll just ask Trip. Are you all right with if we also do, give me a second here. A mic check too, just because this basically is both. Huh?
Wow. A twofer, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gay.
Well, I'm just not a twofer, but it's one. We're doing one video, right? But I'm just gonna play the audio for the mic because it is a mic check kind of thing. Cause it is.
Roger.
Because warning, that Trip.
Yeah, we got the label.
I'm gonna tell you right now. Y'all might need to get y'all helmets. I remember. Remember, we used to throw about helmets. Get your helmets. It's been a while since you didn't get your helmets. Get your helmets. Trip, you got your helmet?
Oops, Dad. Trying to put it on right now.
All right, because this is a mic check, but a mic check and an LBC. Let me roll the intro and then we'll get into what we're talking about. Whew. Cause the South is crazy.
Yo, Nintendo. They got no money, man.
And duo.
What's with this?
Yeah, they're gonna be crazy. Like it back on the mic.
Man, they got no power.
Switch money.
Oh man, we gotta check this.
Just touch down.
Yep. Here we go.
All the haters throw the dust on me. Wait a minute. Let me brush it off, B. Y'all talk about all the millions. Let me check a bank account, homie. Yeah, I made a billion.
Milwaukee's mean, cast my vision. A different path, I'm on a mission.
Gay media, talking division.
We're all trying to take my position.
They ain't try.
Status quo, you stay the same.
You
stay in my lane, but I changed the game.
That's true.
Tell the truth, you should be staying my name. Cause without me, you wouldn't be playing the thing.
Most of y'all wanted to see me stumble.
Mm-hmm.
Behind my back, y'all, I hear the grumbles.
Mm-hmm.
Now that the sun came out and the rain clouds gone, now y'all wanna sing my song.
Ah.
The 8th of January, it brought y'all misery.
Mm-hmm.
Now you wanna rewrite my history.
Woo!
And now with the 1-2 switch, you afraid of my hits? Now I got the industry on lit. Check. Mic check, 1-2-1-2. Mic check, 1-2-1-2. Mic check, now you're on my hit list. Nintendo's back in business. Mic check, 1-2-1-2. Mic check, 1-2-1-2.
So why don't you mind your business? Cause the industry is gonna talk about is my hit list.
All right. Hope y'all ready. Trip, are you ready?
I am ready.
I have the pause button ready to go because it's gonna be some stuff. Let me test my sound clips just to see something.
What? What?
What?
Okay, sound clip ready to go. All right.
So ready to go. My body is ready.
Exactly. So Theo rants, whatever. Nintendo isn't just attacking emulators. Okay. Now, I did a video about with a young man last week about this nonsense, the emulators. And I'm gonna do. I'm also gonna give you the raw version of when I first heard this video. It might not be the best sounding, but I'll give the raw version. But this is between me and Trip, because Trip has never heard this video, and nope. So you guys can hear this.
So I've seen that face, but never played that vid.
Okay, so here's the thing, and I want to state this up front. For all the crazies, all right? I have no problem with you if you're doing it to emulate. If you want to have an emulator and play it with you and just your closest buddies, I get that. I'm cool with that. I'm not a snob. I get it. But when you start showing how to do it online where people could do it, and it's kind of like, that's basically kind of like selling, even though you don't make money off of it, It hurts the product. It just does. All right. So I'm not for
it. I have the same mindset.
I'm not for this. Okay. If you want to emulate, if you want to have a copy for yourself, go right ahead. You have the right for that if you bought it. Funny enough, California just passed a law to show, which is a good law for once in a while you get something, but they're trying to pass a law, which ain't gonna work for the whole country, of course, but they're trying to point out a lot that people have to put down these things, and also a kind of an extra ban and a click to understanding to say that, hey, you know, you don't own this property, you don't own these games, right? These games are software. You're owning a license to rent, and that's it. Even though you pay $50 for the game, it's just a license to rent. And when the game is gone and delisted, you ain't got no rights to it.
Oh yeah, that's right. I've been seeing videos passing around that Sony has been delisting games on their online store. Like,
yep.
Well, that's the online store.
So, and again, Trip is part of this, and I'm part of this. I am team physical. Rah, rah, boom, tie.
Hoorah.
That's why I am. I wait a while for certain games. I wait a while to make sure I got patches and stuff for it. It sucks, but I at least have that. But I am team physical. I'd rather have my game that could play later on than... Funny enough, I have a video in my... Generation N, talking about the last place and the first place, which is first place is Nintendo, last place is Xbox. But it's in the same video talking about how these two companies got to where they are. So, again, remember, check out Generation N Friday, 7 p.m. Eastern. I don't got one video already up, ready to go. And that's what I'm going to do for the next maybe a month and a half. So you'll be some good videos coming up there. Some is short, some is long. So, but again, I'm team physical. I like physical games. Only game I buy digital is games that the mostly indies, and that's about it. If I double dip, I double dip. Like I got Metroid digital, and I got Metroid physically. Yeah, because I'm a Metroid fan, you know? I double dip, whoop, you know? Whoop. Trying to help a franchise, which we'll get back to Metroid as well. We'll get back to that soon. So anyway, so Theo rants, Nintendo isn't just attacking emulators. All right. Well, are you ready, there. Trip?
Yep. Like I said, my body is ready.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
They're bullshit. I get proven wrong aggressively. I am so tired of this. As a lifelong Nintendo fan,
I'm gonna stop making fun of the beginning so you can hear it again.
Every time I think Nintendo's nearly done with their bullshit, I get proven wrong aggressively. I am so tired of this. As a lifelong Nintendo fan, I cannot believe the straight up disdain they have for their community at times, specifically the emulator community. Realistically speaking, the Switch has not been the best way to play Switch games for a while.
Whoa! Wait! What?
What? What the fuck?
Not the... Be- I'm hoping he's going to define what he means by that sentence.
Come on now, Trip.
Look, I get it. The console may not be perfect. That the one I have is a second hand, and I'm surprised that it's still working. But man, the games I play on,
they work. But hey, see, okay, here's how we start this off. Again, my raw version of this is gonna be put up as well too. Like maybe side by side or right beside this video, so y'all can get it. Cause I was like cursing, like what I was saying the same thing, what the hell, and all kind of stuff. But I'm calm down now because I already watched it already. Trip hasn't, but that's just Trip's true reaction. Here's the thing: I buy a PlayStation console to play PlayStation games. So you telling me the best way to not play a PlayStation game is not on a PlayStation console?
Yeah. Also the fact that if it's a first party game, you can't play it anywhere else. Oh, wait a minute. It's not 2020 anymore. So seeing something on PC, but I digress. That's Sony's choice.
Yeah, but here's the thing, Sony. My point is this though. Same thing with you said to Nintendo. And I'm gonna play so you can hear what he said again. But my thing is, if we didn't have the Switch, we wouldn't have the games. Kind of weird to say
exactly that
phrase of Nintendo's not the best place to play Nintendo games.
And also, if it's a game, or should I say, this console is built for a specific game. Where else can you play that game? If the console was built specifically for it, I'm remembering the 1-2 Switch. Someone explained to me where else can I play 1-2 Switch officially?
Okay, all I'm saying is that if we didn't have a Nintendo Switch, we wouldn't have Nintendo Switch games. He said. And I'll repeat, let it replay. And then did you see what I thought about Trip? You see what gameplay he was playing when he was saying that?
Yeah.
So let's go again.
So hear what the man, tomorrow, brother.
Hear what the man say one more time for the people in the back of the crowd.
For their community at times, specifically the emulator community.
That's not their community anyway.
Realistically speaking, the Switch has not been the best way to play Switch games for a while. And it seems.
Okay, that looks like a new Super Mario Brothers. You
that don't even make no goddamn sense.
It could be. Remember, they redid it on the Switch. New Super Mario Brothers is on the on the Switch too.
So let me get this straight. So is the Wii U? Just by using New Super Mario Brothers U as an example, is the Wii U the best place to play Nintendo games?
Well, you wouldn't get the New Super Mario Brothers U if you didn't have a Wii U. And you wouldn't play New Super Mario Brothers Switch without New Super Mario without the Switch.
Viewers, please don't take this the wrong way, maybe you might ostracize me for it. But I am trying very hard.
This is only in 19 seconds. This is only 19 seconds of a 13-minute video. So we got way more to go, Trip. We got way more to go. But I'll rewind it and let it go because you see you want to hear what he's going to say. So I want one more time and you hear one more time the stupid stuff.
Disdain they have for their community at times, specifically the emulator community. Realistically speaking, the Switch has not been the best way to play Switch games for a while. And it seems like Nintendo is very upset about that. We heard earlier this year about how they went after the emulator Yuzu, but it seemed like some of the other emulators, as well as the general emulator community, were safe. That is no longer the case. Not only is Nintendo going after YouTube channels that showcase emulators, not even giving you instructions on how to pirate the games, just showing you what they look like on a console, they went after the safe emulator.
I was about to say pause. When he mentioned Yuzu, I specifically remember that I had seen a video from the Moon Channel basically explaining why Nintendo went after them and put a cease and desist order on Yuzu. He put it out plain when he mentioned about money. That literally made me face palm.
And I'll say
when
this
money was involved, I'm like, yep.
Again, I'll say this for the kids in the back of the class. Who understand this? I mean, Trip talked about this when I was driving home. Most people are not good. Most people are good. I'm sorry. Most people are good, but not by that much. All right. You could say, oh, hey, here's how I got Mario Wii U playing on a phone. Okay. But there are people who still show how to get it on their get an emulator. And then what do those people do? Sell it, show it, do something bad. That's why I said, if it's between your friends or you, cool, you're not. Because there's so much stuff between me and Trip and Addison and you know, Michael, Doc, where we talk about stuff, stays with us. We don't, you get what I'm saying, Trip?
We don't let the whole world to see.
Yeah, all it takes is one person to say, well, you show me how to do this. I could make money off of this. And it spoils the whole thing. That's the problem that a lot of these people never understand. It annoys the hell out of me. Sir, your emulator community is not all saints. And for you to say, Nintendo Switch is not the best place to play Nintendo Switch games.
Allow yourself to slowly get, you're freaking crazy!
Basically.
Yeah. And again, trying to give this man the benefit of the doubt, as in, hey, are these first party games are riddled with bugs and glitches? I mean, it is. Are they so unplayable? Now I get it. The whole unplayable part is subjective, but when I mean unplayable,
you mean like a Fallout.
Fallout 76. Yes.
Oh yeah. It's more than that. Fallout 76, the Star Wars game from Ubisoft. That's broken as hell.
Oh yes, the outlaw. So,
I've seen so many videos of people just falling through things and stuff. And who thought it was a smart idea that this woman could punch a shock trooper with a helmet on and knock him out? How the hell that works?
And you know what? I even tried to give that a bit some leeway. You know, maybe you can knock him out with an open palm. No. She literally got it with,
You got a whole full helmet on. You ain't knocking nobody out with no open palm either.
You might not knock him out, but you might do some damage. But the most damage is
gonna happen to your hand.
Hand.
You punch a baseball helmet and see what happens.
Well, I did say open palm and not closed fist.
Even if you strike with an open hand, it's still gonna hurt as hell, Trip. A baseball helmet
it'll hurt as hell, but not as bad as basically crunching your knuckles in a hard thing.
Correct. But a baseball helmet could take 150 mile power ball. Your hand ain't getting that fast.
Fast. Gotcha.
Just ain't that fast. So no. But again, that's the part about the immune community that I think if you stick to yourself and you do it, I have no problem. Like we just stated up front. But the problem is there's a lot of videos showing that.
Keep it on a down low.
Exactly. And
don't get thing too famous.
Well, yeah, they ain't gonna say famous. Because of what the person what he's gonna say next, I'll say this again. I'll say this up front. The reason they would basically copyright strike that, because they know that you're playing a game on something that you're playing their game on something that they did not say to be
authorized.
Yeah. If you play it on if you play Mario Galaxy on a phone, we know it's not, there's no mobile version of it, or tablet, or PlayStation, or PC.
You Jinx has now been taken down as well. I want to cover all of this because it's absurd, and I hate seeing my fellow YouTube friends, as well as my fellow open source devs, getting attacked by Nintendo's bullshit. It's just
not bullshit, sir. It's business.
Also, considering that he called himself a Nintendo fan, it's quite clear because I consider myself a Nintendo fan, and I'm not angry. I'm just looking at things logically, and I don't even know the intricacies of the law. What, the copyright? But at least I know enough not to do something like this. It's so stupidity, but I digress.
Just, it's infuriating. So, yeah, let's dive in. First, I want to talk about Retro Game Corps. I love this channel. The fact that we have a channel like this is just pure luck, honestly. I don't know how to put it into words, but like...
Listen. Okay, so that's, of course, you can see where he's skewing. That's Zelda Wind Waker. That is not a Switch. That is not a Wii U. And that's not a GameCube.
To be honest, I'm wondering if he actually got the disc or... it's still disc. So I'm wondering if this device is actually playing the GameCube or the Wii, probably the GameCube disc.
I don't know if the GameCube or Wii U. That's, but my point is that right there is not none of those three consoles that game is on. It's not on a Wii U and it's not on a GameCube. Point blank or Wii. Done. It ain't. That's not what a console is.
No, but I'm saying at least if this device is reading the
that trip. Come on.
Yeah, I am just stating it, but I'm doubting it too.
When most of these guys do emulators, they ain't doing it with no disc drive in the back, whatever. They're trying to get an SD card to put it in to get all the games on it.
Yeah, oh boy.
Ain't no disc in that thing right there. That don't look like it. No way that thing has a disc.
Retro Game Corps is a niche channel that covers all of the handheld emulator consoles. He's the go-to channel and blog covering Retroid, covering Embernic, covering Neo, covering the crazy stuff going on with Analog. If you're deep in the world of emulators, you've probably watched multiple of his channels and you might have even followed some of his guides. The amount that this emulator community is riding on him is genuinely difficult to put into words. And seeing him become one of the most relevant YouTubers in the whole gaming space after reading his blog for years has been so heartwarming. And I just want to take the time to shout out Russ because this channel is awesome. And if you're nerdy about these same things, you should be watching this channel. It's especially important to support him now because he just got two strikes from Nintendo. For those who don't understand the way that YouTube's copyright system works, when a copyright holder tries to flag a video, they have two options. Either they can hit the we'll negotiate and give them 1 week button, or they can hit the nuclear button, which is take the video down and put a mark on their channel. And if your channel gets 3 marks, it's gone forever. So you can lose your whole career if you get 3 strikes. It is a...
Damn, I got that. That's sad. Yeah. That sucks.
Yeah, now here's the thing. The reason why I said that old thing before, because I think I've seen one video of this retro game corpse, and for these handhelds, I'm not sure all of them, but the one video I've seen, it actually does read off of a Game Boy cartridge.
Yeah, you said yeah, okay. You said GameCube, disc. You said disc. I said I was going with disc. The analog reads the cartridges you have. I have nothing against that console at all. It's hard to get, but it is a good console. You can play Game Boy, you can play DS games, all that stuff on that console if you have the cartridge. I got nothing wrong with that one. That's all right.
You're basically on the clear with that one.
Yeah, that's one of a few consoles or Retro 5000. You have to put the cartridge and put it inside of the console. Nothing wrong with that. None at all. Nintendo cannot sue you for that because you have a physical copy of the game playing from the physical copy of the game. You can't. That one they can't sue you on. Okay, let's be clear.
So now I'm wondering, these two videos that got strike on, I'm willing to bet
he's gonna tell you. He's gonna tell you what it is.
Yeah, the terrifying.
Please
thing,
let me be wrong.
And because of that, almost nobody does that big nasty strike button. Most people, what they do is just hit the like general copyright dispute button, both because it doesn't kill the channel and because there's a path there where you can get revenue from the ads being served on that. But that's not what they did to Russ. They want his channel gone. They don't want the videos gone. They want his channel gone. So.
Okay. That's what you're saying.
Oh, no.
But I'll say this. Check this out. What does that thing says?
Reviews and setup guides. Oh, sorry.
Oh, yeah. So you're teaching them how to use the emulation. It's like say, hey, again, how to setup guides, how to get the a target, how to get the cell scan to not scan it properly for like 1 cent, and you can walk out with like a TV for 1 cent. It's a setup guide. It is a guide. You literally said up there, if you're a setup guide, and Nintendo is like, wait, our game does not work with this. This doesn't work with that. Though I said, the one over here, the micro Game Boy, not against that, because I can play cartridges. The analog, which is that yellow thing to the right, that's what that is. Even I wanted to buy one of those. Excuse me. I have nothing against that. That one's good, because you have to have the game.
A-okay in my book.
Yeah. Now, you can hack it and make it emulate, of course. You can do that, too. I've seen people do that. And that's what I'm saying. You know what? That's what it is. But if you do it and legitimately have a cartridge, then that's what I'm saying. But, yes. And as he's going to go right now, and I told Tripp about this, and I'm going to say this.
It was gone. They want his channel gone. So some real quick important context on why it seems like things are going nuclear. MIG Flash just put out a new flash cart.
I'll say this. In my video, I'll say up there as well too. I have no problem with, I wish Nintendo could say, hey, you know what? You guys could do it, whatever. I have no problem with the big flash if you bought it and you're backing up your games.
Just for backing up.
Backing up your games. Because again, if I buy a DVD and I could copy the DVD as a backup DVD, which I've done, and I've not given it to nobody, I'm not selling it to nobody, I'm good with that. And I don't think you could do that with the games. The problem is, and the reason Nintendo is coming down on the MIG, is because sell the stuff. The bad people make this look like a parting thing. That's the problem that people keep on forgetting.
Now, here's the thing. Even though if you're the person who made this product, you're going to sell it to some person. It could be a good person, could be a bad person. Now, that one bad person that you sold it to, you probably don't know what he was going to do. But if he's the one that's doing the shady stuff, why do you think you're the one who's going to be target? Oh, because you're the one that supplied him the freaking thing.
Yeah, you supply him the crowbar. You supply him the codes to do all the others. Yeah, that's what it is. So if you're doing this for personal gain, you want to back up these consoles and back up games and stuff like that, I got no problem. And again, I want to say this as well too, because it pisses me off. I got to say this now because of Nintendo fans. You stupid cocksuckers are the reason why we got, again, on a Wii U and a 3DS, I could have sit back up my daggone saves. But because you dumped your bronies in the Wii U and stuff and say, oh, Nintendo should be like PlayStation and Xbox. You should have a cloud and blah, blah, blah. I had two back-to-back debates with, I know, with Player Essence, and I forgot the other guy who was a Player Essence sympathizer. I said, that's not a good idea. I'd rather have my own daggone game, my own save files for me.
And I was, on the sideline, literally face palming, going, these arguments that the guys wanted, you're going to set us back.
And that's what it is. Now you have to have a cloud save to save games. I cannot save games whenever I want it. So when Nintendo, when it inevitably happens, the Switch Online shuts down,
everything goes.
Yeah. And how am I going to save my games?
At least on the 3DS and the Wii U, when you buy your thing, you actually can keep it. And right now, the Switch Online is basically a rental service. So you don't even own those games.
Well, no, you could play the game all you want. But here's the thing.
But
try to play one of them long-ass games and whatever. Because what are you going to save it to?
Yep. But hey, like you said, they were the one who asked for a rental service.
Exactly. So let's continue.
Called the MIG Flash V2. It was called the Switch V2 until Nintendo went after them. What this cartridge does is it lets you take a game dump from a Switch game, put it on an SD card, and then put this in a totally unhacked Switch and be able to play games directly. So yeah, very useful device for backing up your games if you're the type that likes to do that. I know I would have, it's funny to say, but I would have bought a lot more physical games if this existed when the Switch came out, because I would have dumped the physical games, put them on this, and then had this as my like main way of playing stuff, so I didn't have to carry 15 physical games with me all the time.
And then you want to
know
why?
Are you for real?
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Buy more physical.
I did tell you this, like, because the bad ones are basically spoiling everything. This is you want physical games. You want those physical games to be kept, to be made. Well, situations like this, the rotten apples, are actually making Nintendo reconsider that, you know what, maybe we might go all digital.
Yep. That's why I said that stuff is messing with me too.
You say you want to preserve your kid. No, I'm going ahead of myself.
I wish Bishwetter went to, but then, but he just said, I will buy more physical games. Why don't you just buy more physical games? That's the better way to preserve it. That's the best way to preserve it. I'm sorry. Because even if you got digital game, again, the same problem you still have. And, but at least the thing is, when the server go down, you can't play your game that you want. I can. Like I said, I have more than enough games to play. Ain't no way I'm going to beat all the games I have for this Nintendo, for the Nintendo Switch. And I'm hoping. And I'll be honest right here, right now. I'm not going to lie. I'm going to be honest with, because I don't lie. I'll be honest right now. If somebody comes up with a way that I could save my, that could back up my save files to an SD card like he just said right there, and it works on a Switch, without that I'm gonna use that hack. I'm not gonna lie. Cause ain't no way I can play Yeez 8, 9, and 10 without, and save to what? I ain't got no save to save to. Those are long ass games.
And I'm the type of person, I like to keep things separately. Cause I'm like, if I put all my games on this cartridge, if that cartridge, literally, if something bad happens to that cartridge, all my games are gone on that.
Yep.
Now, so I guess I'm the crazy person that, you know, I'd like to keep my games separated from each other.
Yeah. Well, like I said, on my channel right now, I have a video to show how people how to back up their Wii U games and preserve their Wii U games. I've got it on the channel, Wii U games, because you want to keep the Wii U games going. So if somebody comes up with a way to back up the Switch games saves, I mean, it's not the games itself, the saves, and I can access saves. It to the game could read it and know, hey, I'm this whatever. Because like some of the games I have, like the Gundam game, oh my god, I'm like 300 hours in that game. 300, or let's go into what? Xenoblade Chronicles X on the Wii U. I have over 150 hours on that game, but I have a physical place where it's backed up. Two places. I have it on a thumb drive, and I have it on a hard drive.
I probably got 300 hours in that game.
My point is, the Wii U's network is down. You didn't have to worry about that because the save was to your DAG on what? SD cards or hard drive.
On your, yep.
This shit right here? No. Nope. That's the stupid part. All I want is my saves. I don't want nothing else, if anything, to back up. I want my own saves. Nintendo need to make it that you go, hey, give me my saves. I don't give a damn about no cloud.
On top of that, it's worth noting that if you play pirated copies of games, Nintendo's aggressively keeping an eye on those and flagging and banning consoles that play.
No shit.
What? Did you just give them the point? Oh my gosh.
That's why Nintendo will. And they were doing that for the Wii U too, sir. When you hack your Wii U and they update it, it basically brick your console. I remember that. Remember the good old Wii U days when people were like arguing and bitching on YouTube. Nintendo brick my console. Yeah, because you...
And I'm like, what did you do with it? Did you overstep in that gray area?
I homebrew it. Well, there you go.
Like, no wonder. Yep. Again... When people ask to basically have everything online, you know that you literally ask them to open your rear because you're literally on their turf online.
Yep. Has to be. And that's because of that stupid reason. I did a video. What video did? Did I put it up? The video I put up. Did I put that video up? I think I did put a video up. I thought, it's the same thing with the other guy, the young kid. When I said I couldn't play my digital game at the car dealership because it had to online check. I didn't have to do that with my Wii U. I didn't have to do that with my 3DS. Once I downloaded the game and it's on my console, I can play anytime, anywhere.
Yep.
But because y'all BS, now we have to do, even though I download the game, I have to do an internet check.
Play a version with a license that is from one of those pirated copies. So if you're not dumping legit cartridges and putting them on here, you might be fucked. So Nintendo's not happy about this, to be very clear.
No shit.
They're going ham on this. And that's where this current arc started. Retro Game Corps obviously did a video covering this because it fully falls within the things that he covers. And Nintendo copyright struck the video. And the way that they were able to do that is because he was playing Nintendo games in the video showcasing it. And they DMCA struck his gameplay of their game, claiming that their games is their copyright. So he isn't able legally to play it in his videos, even though everyone else can. It's just a retaliatory strike.
Yes, it is. Because again, play. Yeah, here's the thing. They are going after him. Why? Because again, he's playing a game on something that's not officially a Nintendo console. That's why they struck it down.
I'm like, it's like you literally gave them the go ahead to play with your career. Saying it nicely.
Technically speaking, any game dev could strike any YouTuber showcasing their game in their videos unless they have explicit permission from the game developer. But no one does that.
Oh, yes, they do.
Another video from the Moon Channel basically discussed this when it came to a certain YouTuber that they literally modded Breath of the Wild to make it multiplayer. And I'm like, are you freaking serious, man? And you know what? During the Wii U days when YouTubers were basically making the argument, they bought the game officially, legally. And whatever they stream from that game, any choice that they make is basically their own, falls under fair use. And I'm like, you know what? You got a point there. But then when you are basically playing the game in the way that is outside the confine of what they were designed, that's literally IP tampering. Just saying.
Again, and there have been people who've copyright struck for different things. Okay, so let's not pretend that at all. All right, so let's get back to as you said.
It's just insane.
I get the fair.
I've never seen.
Go ahead.
Sorry, I get the fair use part, but again, when you're as a content creator, when you're really overstepping your boundaries, you literally give them the go ahead to go for you.
I could give a great example. Now, even though I don't watch that channel no more, it's a cluster F. I stopped watching that channel since 2019, really, but it's a cluster F. Go back to the old style of Jim Sterling. How much people copyright and strike some of these videos because he used to give bad reviews to games, but when he used to do the indie games on the PCs and stuff. A lot of those devs was doing that to him.
You know what? It's weird that he. Maybe it's just me that I haven't seen that one particular video, but
not one particular video. It was multiple times when
multiple videos.
It was multiple videos. He used to talk about like scary, any video that like some scary movie, and it was just like his asset flips, whatever. And they used to copyright his videos because they say, because I said that it was asset flips and it was a crappy game or whatever. He done multiple videos. I've seen maybe about 20, 30 videos that he's done with people. The game designers did that to him.
Dang, well, my mind must not be as good these days. But for some,
that's Jim starting from 2015 to 2018.
Yeah, I understand. But the one video that actually got more attention than these, and I'm just guessing here, and I might probably be wrong, but the one video that got most shine on is when it came to Nintendo.
I guess that the shine of what it stood out for those things, yes, but that's back then when he used to play, he used to do videos, you know, he used to put up videos every other day and all the stuff, and you see it. Most of the videos was right. Talking about how people asset flips. That's a lot of VM selling stuff was back then.
You know what? Yeah, I do remember those asset flip videos. Oh, wow.
And there were people who didn't like what he says to this, to the copyright strike, or they say they're going to sue him and all kind of stuff.
Yeah, that was bad. I gotta say, that was bad.
So, So it's not Nintendo only. You know, don't say that. It ain't. All right? And like I said, I have gotten a copyright strike from a hard strike from Sony. I wasn't talking bad about it, but because of what I said, and I said because it was stupid, I didn't say bad, I said stupid, they copyright, they'll give me a hard strike on something as well too. Now it's been a long time that happened, so my child's back down to being a good little boy because I ain't getting no trouble. Now have I gotten copyright strikes? The soft one, like he said, yes. The hard one, that was Sony a long time ago, yeah. And I was surprised that Sony did that, but hey, we ain't hearing me bitching and whining. It is what it is. Move on. Now, what I said in my raw video of this, and what this guy needs to do is, and I said it to Jim Sterling as well, to when Jim Sterling was talking about stuff, and also Angry Joe. You guys have websites. Why don't you just tell people go to the website and create your own, have your own videos there? If you have your own video there, they can't sue you for that. And do what you want, a tutorial and stuff like that. That's what you should do. Just say, hey, you guys want to see what's going on? Head over to retrogamechops.uk. Being that it's in a different country, just say that, .uk, okay, you can buy that. And then, hey, you can see how to use the Uzi emulator, whatever. Boom, done. And don't put the stuff on your YouTube channel if that's somewhere you make money off of that. That's kind of like the smart thing to do.
Yeah, and besides, you have the company that you're literally being annoyed with. It's literally on YouTube as well.
Exactly.
Anything like this ever, and I can't believe they're doing this this way. One more thing I forgot to mention is if your channel gets struck, it's not like you can just go make a new one. You as an individual are banned from YouTube forever. So if you get three strikes on a channel, you don't get to do YouTube anymore.
That channel gets banned. No, it ain't. You can make other channels. It's linked to the email. If they find some way to do it to the IP, which is the computer, well, you could switch the IP. So, yeah.
And since these people are since these individuals are tech savvy, should be easy for them.
I'm a techie, but I'm not tech savvy, but I know you could do that because I've seen other people do it. That's why I say that.
Right.
Genuinely terrifying stuff. So this happened. You could make the argument that he was showing tools for piracy specifically. And
thank you.
No, there, boom, that's it. That's just what they need. And you gave them.
Nintendo was really sensitive about that. which sucks. And if this was just a one-time thing with this one video and them going after the cartridge, I would probably not be covering this. But with Nintendo, it's never just one thing. It's
again, Chip knows about this, my radio channel that I have. I got copyright strike from CBS for something that they produced. I'm not going to say they didn't, but it was in a video. But I didn't show it from CBS. I showed it from another video, which is also a bigger YouTube, because it's a corporation that shared a video to show. I was talking about Black fathers and what they're important to Black people. But for some reason, they never touched those. And I did the video multiple times because I was trying to show them, you know, why Black fathers are important. They ain't touched that video for years until this August has just passed. Three videos got struck down because of that. Outright block.
From every country.
Yeah. Well, it's blocked on YouTube. It's not that. So what I did is I showed why, whatever, and people saw it, and they kind of fuming about it. But there you go. Because I was fair using it. I was talking to it, and that was nowhere close to the whole show. As Trip knows it, it's a short video. It was just easy, boom, boom, boom. I was talking to it like I'm talking to it right now. And then I move on to show why, the reasons or whatever, blah, blah, blah. It was like maybe what? It was like two to three minutes. But you block a two-hour video. But that's the rules. So I just move on. It is what it is.
Never they hit a threshold and are pushing back. It seems like they're on a bit of a bender, because they took down one of his videos a few days later because he was just playing Wind Waker. So now if he plays
on a console that's not a Wind Waker console, again.
Okay. The reason why I set it up that I'm hoping that he's actually using the GameCube disc, the inserted to play that game on this machine, but. Like you said, Liger, I'm sorry to believe that. Yeah, like you said, it's not the case. And I'm like, I'm not surprised why this got struck down.
Any Nintendo game, they might DMCA strike him, and he might lose his channel entirely. Here's his post that he made on the YouTube community. Hi, friends. Well, it does appear that my worst fears are true, and I'm being specifically targeted by Nintendo. If almost anyone said that they felt like they were being targeted by Nintendo, I would call them a conspiracy theorist. He is. He is absolutely being targeted by Nintendo. There's no conspiracy theory here. This is just what is happening. My Wii U video was taken down and I received another copyright strike, even though the showcase video was no different than all of the tech demos and reviews I've made on this channel previously. I am still considering a counterclaim under fair use, as the video was for educational use, transformative in nature, and it had no effect on the market. It was a demonstration of a console no longer for sale.
No longer for sale, but yet you just showed that, hey, it can be done.
That's
so
not my
if
problem.
It's no longer for sale, if it's no longer for sale, yeah, but if it's no longer for sale, why did you post the video anyways?
Well, that's not the problem. I can see why they posted the video. I can see why he posted the video. Here's the thing, though. Just like they did with the Metroid, when they had the Metroid MRS, SRR, whatever, the animated one. And then right after that they had Metroid Samus Return right after it. Because you don't know what they're doing with their IP. That's why they struck it down. They might be doing a Zelda for Switch. Wind Waker for Switch. You don't know. And that's not your right to know, because that's their property. Just saying.
The Wii U eShop is closed, so the company itself has no means of earning revenue from Wii U sales. However, I am reluctant to open that can of worms with a multi-billion-dollar corporation, as their next step would be to file legal action. At the very least, this means I am going to change how I approach future videos. I will no longer show any Nintendo games on screen, which is a shame because I love using those games for my hardware demonstrations. I don't know how this will play out when it comes to showing things like the ESD front-end themes that contain Nintendo characters, but for now, I'm going to focus on actual gameplay. I'm also going through the videos I'm working on, blurring out any Nintendo game.
I'm wondering, okay, since he's not going to use Nintendo make games, then is he going to use, Sony's first parties, Xbox division's first parties, third parties? Because I'm willing to bet probably might not like it either. Especially certain, if they're still
certain ones. Yeah, not all of them going to do stuff, but certain
ones. Not all of them.
Certain ones gonna be. I mean, Square might say something about some certain games. If you do that, just saying. Namco Bandai might say the same thing too. Capcom might say the same thing too.
Oh, definitely. Yep.
So, you gotta be picky. You just gotta be picky. But whatever. I mean, sorry, bro.
Choose your battles.
Yeah.
Content as a precaution. Even innocuous content like NES games. Unfortunately, this is going to delay some video releases. My latest video should be up right now, but instead I have to re-edit and re-upload the video first. I know this is disappointing news, but now with two strikes on my channel, I don't really have any other choice except to adjust accordingly. Thanks for your understanding. I just cannot believe that this happened. To do this to a YouTuber who's a huge fan of Nintendo is hard to fathom. This reminds me of when they went after Point Crow. I'm not one to say boycott the company, but I am much more hesitant.
That was the YouTuber I was looking for. That was the YouTuber's name that I was looking for. Point Crow. That the Moon Channel made a video of it. Okay. For him to mention Point Crow, I'm like, do you not see the problem? And just on the cherry on top, another YouTuber, Moon Channel, also a lawyer, basically told you in little details the reason why they went after him. You know what, like, it's, yeah, you're right. Like, in the last video you made about that other chap, when they're saying something or when they're telling you something, they are really obfuscating some other data. Sorry, continue.
No, that's all right. I got you.
To buy Nintendo things going forward, knowing that this is how they treat people who are the strongest enthusiasts and the ones trying their hardest to preserve the entire Nintendo ecosystem.
That's not your job.
That
is not your job. You buy the game. Go ahead.
It's really ironic. The one company that you're annoyed of, so you can preserve the game, is the one company that's actually preserving their games, even if it's behind closed doors, they're still preserving their games. Again, do we have to bring up what's the game? The Child of Mana, or I think I got the name wrong, but. Yeah, one of the Mana games where Square Enix didn't have their original source code. You know where it came from? Nintendo. The irony there. Yep. But I digress.
And once again, Russ's info's in the description. Please go give him a subscription. Please watch a few of his videos. I think you'll be surprised how absurdly good and detailed they are. He's one of the most thorough reviewers in the industry, and he's just doing like the amount of money he's making on that channel is nothing compared to the effort he's putting in. So for Nintendo to go after him like this and make his job that much harder, it deeply disturbs me. It is so, as a fellow YouTuber, the thought of a company making my life this much harder for this dumb of a reason, it makes me feel sick. And
again,
you get permission,
I'll say it one more time. Best way for people to not F with you is you go after everybody. Let them know I'm not to F with.
No matter how big or small.
Or small. Exactly. Exactly.
And Russ, I hope you know how much we appreciate you and how horrible this is. You're one of my biggest inspirations for doing YouTube, and seeing this happen to you sucks. It sucks so hard. And know that I and others are prepared to stand with you and fight. This sucks.
Fight doing what? That buy Nintendo games? Whoa. Ooh. I'm shaking in my knees here, man. Freaking hell.
Oh, shiver me timbers.
Exactly.
Sucks. This just fucking sucks. But that's not the only thing they did. Nintendo also decided to go after the remaining emulator, Ryujinx. For a bit more context from before, Nintendo took down Yuzu earlier this year because people were using it to play the new Zelda game before it was even out.
Are you freaking kidding me? Did you literally just give them a point why they went after him? Or them? Before release? You can't make this thing up.
No. And for reference, let me show you right here as Triple C, you'll see the screen. Look what this is. Legend of Zelda Echo Wisdom Yuzu emulated gameplay. The game just fucking came out.
When's the date of this upload?
It made no difference. It's a brand new game, Trip.
5 days.
I don't care.
No. 5 days ago, like you said, brand new. So that means you just gave the possibility to any bad actors out there don't want to pay for this game. Well, they'll pirate it. And guess what? That literally goes on Nintendo that, hey, they just lost sales right there.
That's what do you think happened to Metroid Dread? This is the same shit happening. Kotaku, you assholes who showed how to do it.
Oh my God.
How the hell are you a game journalist showing people how to steal? What kind of shit is that?
I'm like, who's the freaking editor at Kotaku? I mean, you literally gave a company a green light to go, oh, I'm a half that behind of yours.
This game came out a week ago, literally, and it's already on y'all emulating the shit.
And in public, see me here, people. No wonder you are the bullseye.
So that points out my point. Oh, and again, for what? To get what? Oh, I want 4K graphics. Well, this is not even ain't worth it. Like, why? I'll give you one thing and one thing only in anything. Nintendo rushed this game, so it's not optimized fully. I'll send it. That's on Nintendo's fault.
We'll admit that.
Yeah, but still, that's a new brand new game it just got. So, y'all like to just mess with shit. Again, when I said Metroid, people are like, oh, Metroid Dread should have sold 10 million easy on the Switch. Not the freaking 5. 10. Well, all the other games are up, all the other games up there. What is that, Trip?
I was saying, for all that, all those praise that the Metroid IP was getting, like you said, you would think that it would sell at least 10 million.
And it costs us over 150 million? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I digress. So there you go. So you could play a Zelda game and stuff, and you could play this other Zelda game when it just came out. This is the problem they have against it, you butt munches. Jeez. Stupid. The arguments are so dumb.
Again, even I don't know the intricacy of the laws, but at least I am not dumb enough to do something like this if I was this tax savvy. And yes, you can argue that the laws hasn't catched up to the tech, and that's the reason why oh no, we're like, okay, so why can't you wait until the laws pass?
With the I don't really care about the laws in this situation. It's just decency. Look, I made a product, you like it, you buy it. If you don't like it, you don't buy it. Move on. Don't steal the shit. Because again, if you steal from Target, like as we gave an example earlier, and Target goes away, you can't buy nothing from Target because that Target's gone. And then who gets hurt? The people who wanted Target in that neighborhood. The good people who are not stealing whatever got to suffer because a few jackasses went in there and keep on robbing the place.
Law-abiding citizens.
And the version that worked for that game was behind a Patreon paywall. And it seems like Nintendo's specific trigger is people making money off of what they see as piracy and directly hurting their sales.
Did he just literally say exactly what I've said at the beginning of the video when it comes to money?
Oh, my God.
Again, do I have to keep repeating myself? The Moon Channel made specifically a video about this. And he's a freaking lawyer.
Yes, sir. I don't want you to take money from my games. Yes. What's the other question? Just like, again, it's just you. It sounds like a leftist person when you're like, oh, well, they only stole a couple of bread and a bread because they had to feed their family. No, they didn't have to feed no damn family. They stole because they want to steal.
I'm like, you don't call yourself Robin Hood.
And again, that story has been twisted over the years. Robin Hood didn't steal from the rich to give to the poor. He steal from the unjust to give to the just. That's what the original story of Robin Hood was. But it's been twisted.
I can hear the argument there. I still think it's kind of annoying, but I can hear the argument.
Oh, is it kind of annoying to have that kind of argument? Oh, wow.
Whoop-de-doo. So you're not that... Okay. Let's say it like this. So you're not that incompetent. You know, which one is much more egregious? To call him stupid or incompetent or dumb? Because I'm trying to be... I am trying very hard to be nice.
Anyway...
None of that is what happened with Ryujinx. Ryujinx is not behind a paywall. I don't even know if they have a Patreon. I'm pretty sure they don't. It is a pure, traditional, open source project that has a lot of people working hard to preserve Switch games indefinitely. And they
It's kind of weird that you're doing Switch games right now. The console ain't even gone yet, but you switch. But whatever.
You're not the only one.
I've been told to take it down. Yesterday, yes. GDK Chan was contacted by Nintendo and was offered an agreement to stop working on the project, remove the organization, and all related assets he's in control of. While awaiting confirmation on whether he would take this agreement, the organization has been removed, so I think it's safe to say what the outcome is. Rather than leave you with only panic and speculation, I decided to write this short message to give some closure. These words are my own. I don't want to speak for anyone else here, so just remember that while reading. Thank you to everyone who has contributed code, documentation, or issue reports to this project. Thank you all for following us throughout this development. So able to learn a lot of really neat things about the games that I love, enjoy them with renewed qualities and in unique circumstances. And I'm sure you all have experiences that are similarly special. I'm extending my own massive thanks to our moderation team who has been here through some rough circumstances and always found ways to make light of it. Almost forgot to mention, Nintendo is getting into even more frivolous bullshit right now. They're actually going after Pal World. I can't believe this. I'm like, how can we do this?
I'm skipping that because I already did a video about it. And I'm not going to rehash that shit again. Just ain't.
Right.
And it also feels like they took all of their litigious bullshit and bundled it all at once, which is insane. I cannot believe this. Apparently, with Japanese copyright law, it's not unlikely they can win even more bullshit.
I just want to say this. Yeah, it took this long for Nintendo to file a lawsuit against Pal World, and I'm like, you know what? Why do you think it took so long? because they were all that time they were building a case, and they literally said, when all this was happening, that they were looking into it. So
it's mostly Pokemon, and also it's mostly Pokemon Company, really.
Pokemon Company.
Yeah, Nintendo really too. This part I do know. They really don't care, but it's Pokemon Company is mostly the suit because they have they're playing on a Nintendo console and stuff. It goes that way with how how playthroughs and stuff work in Japan. That's where people point it. It's basically the Pokemon Company,
right? So yeah, I'm surprised people are actually surprised by this incoming, which I'm like.
Yeah, so I'm just gonna Let me just, like I said, I ain't gonna rehash that. That's just not me saying.
Right.
Pokemon games. That is such bullshit. God. And no, but before people start saying this, because I do every time, there are so many forks. People can just maintain the forks. No. The people who are capable of building things like this, maintaining them, pushing them as far as they've been pushed, those people don't take these risks lightly. The types of developers who are talented enough to reverse engineer the Switch and build something like Ryujinx or Yuzu are not the types of devs that'll put their whole lives at risk because they like playing video games. It's just not realistic. The task.
So if that's the case, then so they're doing it for a purpose for what? As an old video game saying, is an old saying. No one know the evil that lurks in the hearts of men.
Unless you're God, which you're not.
I'm not.
Task is already hard enough.
I mean, well,
Nintendo making it this much harder is not making them more motivated. It's making them significantly less so. And the likelihood that we see some new devs take on this challenge and do as good of a job, knowing that Nintendo's breathing down their necks the whole time, it's not low. It's zero. For the time being, this is the end of Switch emulation.
Isn't that idea? You can go play of a system deceased? Sorry, isn't that the idea of a system deceased?
Yeah, you're correct.
Wow, how ironic, making the point. Impressive.
Old builds of these emulators, sure, some new games will work, but a future where these tools are getting meaningful updates as time goes on, it's not going to happen. It's over. And Nintendo, it sucks, but they won. I don't know what they win here. They achieved their...
They keep the IP from being stolen.
Yeah. On top of that, I'm like, why couldn't these people actually wait until after the next generation Nintendo console came by?
That'll make no difference. It makes no difference.
Stop selling? It makes no difference.
Because he just brought up a Wii U. So it makes no difference.
Right.
It's their IP. They do what they want to do with their IP. That's who did with it. What do you want me to say? It's their stuff. It's not mine. It's somebody else's own. That's the way it is.
Right. Kind of the old Disney with Mickey Mouse thing.
Their goal. They have demotivated the emulator community to the point where people are just going to not show Nintendo stuff to the best of their ability. And I've seen plenty of other Nintendo adjacent YouTubers.
Can they show official stuff? Sorry.
That's not the point.
Everything. But this reminds me of the old days where Nintendo would go after random YouTube channels for just playing a game. It seems like they've fully lost the plot. I know that the culture where they are
not
is different,
really.
That the ability to go after people for copyright is much stronger, and the culture around fair use and doing these types of things is not the same in Japan, but it doesn't excuse the absolute terrible behavior they're engaging with here, crushing the dreams of individuals who are trying to make these things that they love accessible to more people over longer windows of time.
Then buy the freaking get. Oh boy.
No, son of a bitch.
As much as I want to agree that egregious behavior, I'm like, you know what? There's a lot of stuff you're saying that it's not really egregious. Basically, they're right, and even though it's a company, It's a company run by individuals who also have rights to protect what they own.
Right now, I can't say for sure if I'll be able to show my children my favorite Switch games in 10 years, because
that's the part that kill me.
Are you? No, no, no.
What do you mean you can't?
No, no, no.
I mean, how you can't? If you buy a physical Nintendo Switch game, you can show them in 10 years. I mean, look, I have 1-2 Switch that came out. I came out day and day with the Switch in 2017. It's been going on 7 years now. I still could show it. Let me help you out. I got Nintendo World. I got Nintendo Land on the Wii U. That came out in 2012. It's been 10 years. I could show that.
I got an NES control deck, second version. I got a Nintendo 64. I got a Wii. They still work.
I got a Metroid 2 Game Boy game from 1992.
Oh, so, speaking about that, I got a Game Boy Color. Sure, the screen needs repairing, but I can still play it. I can still play my Game Boy Color games on it. I can still play my Game Boy games on it. They still work. So for this, try to keep it respectable.
Let's watch the end then.
That Nintendo is done to destroy every preservation effort is impossible to work around. So to all of the developers and all of the creators who have been affected by this, I am truly, truly sorry. And to Nintendo, fuck you.
You're literally doing that to yourself.
Basically, as a Nintendo fan. Sir, I'm sorry that you are a...
You piece of loser.
I'm sorry. Just play the games and move on. That's it. That's all. Do that and move on.
And how about wait until the copyright actually expires?
That as well. I mean, seriously.
And also, they stop renewing it too.
I don't understand these gamers at all. This is YouTube anyway, so I'm not surprised by that. But like I just showed right there, there already is a Zelda they already done emulating Zelda Echoes of Wisdom. Game just came out a week ago.
You literally gave Nintendo the potential for good reasons to say, hey, this is actually hurting us financially.
Yep.
You know And you know what? The judge is going to agree.
Y'all did it with Metroid. Y'all did it with Tears of the Kingdom. Y'all did it with Odyssey. Y'all did it with Breath of the Wild. Y'all did it with all that shit. All right? That's what the problem is.
Stop giving them the ammunition to go and put a cap in.
Oh, well. But there you go. Trip, see it. Now you see what I said when I said Trip. It's craziness. All right. And there's a lot more videos of people who follow this stupidity and stuff like that. Whatever. I don't care. Look, I love my pastime, but I can't, like I said. I love my pastime, but best thing I could tell anybody out there, buy the physical game when you think there's a good enough patches to fix it and stuff like that. And then you're good. you have the money, then at least you'll be future protecting. Because again, I have me a Switch, I have me a Switch Lite, and I have me a Switch OLD. And if the Switch 2 has backwards capability, then I have, that'll be like four consoles I have that could play Switch games. You know?
You know, I have to say this. When he said about the whole game preservation, and I'm like, again, using the example of a 1-2 Switch, you do know if it's, the game is the only thing that you're going to preserve. What about the device that you need to play that game, that the device was designed for that game?
They don't.
Are you going to preserve the hardware too?
Of course
too?
Not. No, because you emulate it. That's literally against what they just said. They emulate it to play on a PC.
Which is why I'm like, you're not preserving the entirety of the experience.
No, they're not. But whatever. I mean, y'all bitched on Nintendo. Look at last year. This year, last year, y'all got games that were stuck on Super Nintendo and GameCube. You got Thousand Year Door. You got Mario RPG.
Super Mario RPG.
You got those games on a Switch. So there you go.
Let's not forget. Even though it's not physical. The two last F-Zero games that were, both of them were Japan only. Again, for the first time, in stateside to officially play. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, let's not forget, remake of Detective Club. Also, yep. Japan only.
That's why I told you when you were saying about let the generation dead. I'm like, no, because they might have, it's their IP. They might want to put it, take an old IP and put it on their console. That's their IP. That's what they want to do. That's what they do. So, yep. Don't care. Do not care. Like I said, I stated my point. Then sorry, guy, that you think that's what it is. All right.
I got less F to give.
Basically. So.
Because I'm like, as much as the arguments they bring, I'm like, well, you do know that those are the laws. The laws are really not for you. Maybe why didn't you, try to change the laws or, change the culture, but. I guess that's too hard.
Nope. But anyway, that's Tripp's advice. My advice is just buy what you want to buy. If you don't like it, don't like it. You say you ain't gonna support Nintendo? Don't. You have that right. Don't buy that shit. It's not that hard. I don't support Xbox because I don't buy no Xbox games. Why? Because I don't own the games if I get an Xbox. Even though I'm a PC. I don't own it, so. No, I'm good.
Yep.
So again, my raw watching this video, like uncut raw, I'll post with this video as well to y'all. I just wanted Trip because Trip didn't, he was talking. He's like, I don't know. And then now you heard his reaction as it raw as well too.
So. The helmet that I'm wearing, well, basically I'm wearing half of it because that last one really broke it in half for me.
Oh, boy. Exactly. So, again, LBC people, that's what it is. If you guys be kindly, don't forget every Friday at 7 p.m., there is a problem. There is a video called Gen N. Again, leave your comments. There you want to say in there, talk about what's going on. And also, like I said, I've been talking with Trip and we've been talking about stuff. You might get a special podcast this Sunday if y'all be care if how things work out. But I am trying to get the old as best I can, the old school and cast back up. So let's see how that works. If y'all want that, let me know. And from that on, remember, there's no perfect games out there. None. What's perfect to you is not perfect to me. What's perfect to me is not perfect to you. Simply enjoy games on all consoles, including PC. Peace out.
Play like you live in it.